like, see, I got my this one is third. All right, second.
Thank you. Thank you. God, we thank you so much for our time here together, for all the friends we have made, for all the days of laughter and fun, and for all we have learned. We thank you for those who have given their time and energy so that we can graduate today. Our teachers, coaches, family, and friends, we thank you for them and give them to you in prayer. As this chapter of our life closes, we present ourselves as an open book in front of you. Come and write your word of life into our lives. Fill our minds with your thoughts, fill our bodies with your strength, fill our hearts with your dreams, that we might eternally love and serve you this day and every day forward. This in your name we pray.
Good afternoon. We are gathered today to celebrate and validate the Holcomb High School class of 2018. I am Trey Gilbert, your class president of 2018. I would like to welcome parents, families, and friends of the graduates as they join us for this achievement. I would also like to thank the families and faculty members of Holcomb High School for supporting and preparing us for this journey. But last but not least, I want to thank my family and my friends for making me the man I am today. That being said, let's get a better set of the class of 2018.
Thank you, Trey. We'd like to start off this afternoon by recognizing six students who went through their entire high school career with a 4.0 GPA. Those students, please come forward. Please congratulate the individual, Megan Burrows. Trey Gilbert. Kyle Hammond. Emma Mangles. And Kinsey Soto. I invite back to the stage and recognize our salutatorian, Stephen Crane. Time flies. We've gone to school for 13 years, and today is our last day. Although 13 years seems like a long time, it's really just a flash. It seems like just yesterday we were taking naps in school and learning how to count. We've done a lot of interesting things in our school years. In third grade, we learned about science with the crawfish Olympics. In fifth fifth grade, you got Big Macs for learning multiplication. In sixth grade, you made TVs with Mr. Perez. In seventh and eighth grade, we got activity period taken away for playing tackle football. As freshmen, we really didn't know what was going on, and we were trying to figure out what high school was all about. But starting in our sophomore year, we really started to strive in our high school activities. Our class has been involved in many different clubs and organizations. We've won 5 state championships and have had many other state appearances. We've had a lot of success in our high school careers within those different organizations. Although it really isn't apparent to us, we're leaving a tremendous legacy for our school and our community. It doesn't seem like what we've been doing for the last 13 years has left much of an impact, but our class will be remembered. We have left impressions in many different ways in our schools, and personally, I've heard from multiple teachers that they still remember our class and what we did back in elementary school. The small things like that make me realize the impact that we've had in our 13 years. Even though high school seems like it's taken a long time, it's really just the start of our lives. Some people are going off to college, some are going to a trade school, and some are just going straight to the job market. It may seem scary, but we only need to continue what we've been doing for the past 13 years. Whatever city, college, or career you go into, continue to make an impact wherever you go. It's been a fun 13 years, and I hope you succeed in whatever you choose to do with your life.
Singers sing For Good. Thank you. Now let me introduce our valedictorian this year, Megan Burrows. Dixon, Trey Gilbert, Kyle Hammond, Emma Mangles, Chesney McVeigh, Brittany Novak, Jordan Ramsey, Maria Salamanca, Ebony Sapien, Taylor Sleep, and Kenzie Soka. Students that were recognized as Kansas Honors recipients. They were Megan Burrows, Stephen Crane, Kobe Dixon, Trey Gilbert, Kyle Hammond, Emma Mangles, Taylor Sleep, and Kenzie Soka. Going through 4 years of high school is challenging enough. We recognize 4.0 students. We're going to recognize those students who went through all 4 years of high school and played a sport in all three of the seasons that were available. They are referred to as our 12 sport athletes. We have six of those from this class that received this award. They are Carter Blackburn, Chesney McVeigh, Chance Rodriguez, Ebony Sapien, Caden Tishner, and Courtney Ring. Out of this group, we had one that qualified as a Regent Scholar, meeting all the requirements that have to do with upper-level classes as well as foreign language classes that they took when they were in high school. And our one Regent Scholar this year, Megan Burrows. Dale Dennis Educational Excellence or Excellence in Education Award is given out annually to a graduate in each of the schools in Kansas. And the Dale Dennis Excellence in Education recipient for this class, Stephen Crane. Great West Activities Conference that Holcomb is a member of with Goodland, Colby, Scott City, Holcomb, Cubington, and Ulysses gives out all academic awards to students who maintain a 3.5 GPA or higher and who have lettered in an activity. And we have a number of those students that have qualified for GWAC All Academic. They are Carter Blackburn, Megan Burrows, Chris Chandler, Nicole Coates, Stephen Crane, Kobe Dixon, Ephraim Flores, Bailey Foreman, Trey Gilbert, Kyle Hammond, Maddie Knoll, Devin Mater, Emma Mangles, Chesney McVeigh, Chris Nemechek, Cameron Newman, Brittany Novak, A.J. Ortega, Jordan Ramsey, Ebony Sapien, Taylor Sleep, Kinsey Soka, Caden Spencer, Caden Tishner, Garrett Williams, and Courtney Rand. Year the head coaches select a male and female athlete to be recognized at graduation. They are Trey Gilbert and Ebony Sapien. Annually, Holcomb letters those who academically have the required GPA. As freshmen, you're required to have a 3.9, as a sophomore, you're required to have a 3.9, as a junior, you're required to have a 3.8, and as seniors, you're required to have a 3.7 GPA to earn an academic letterman from Holcomb High School. And from this class, those include Megan Burrows, Chris Chandler, Stephen Crane, Kobe Dixon, Tania Fairbank, Bailey Foreman, Trey Gilbert, Natalie Granados, Kyle Hammond, Maddie Knoll, Devin Mater, Emma Mangles, Chesney McVeigh, Michael Peterson, Jordan Ramsey, Sheila Robles, Maria Salamanca, Ebony Sapien, Taylor Sleep, Kenzie Soka, Caden Spencer, Caden Tischner, and Garrett Williams. Kansas State High School Activities Association honors two students from every school with a citizenship award. The citizenship award is presented for excellence as an exemplary young citizen who has demonstrated a marked respect for country, assumed responsibility for improving school and community, and has shown reverence for life. And the recipients of the Acacia Citizenship Award, Stephen Crane and Taylor Sleep. And our final award presentation goes to the most inspirational. The students selected a most inspirational student from amongst themselves, and the faculty selected a most inspirational from their viewpoint as well. The faculty, most inspirational student, Zeke Labor. And from the fellow students, most inspirational student, Trey Gilbert. At this time, the seniors wish to present the Outstanding Teacher of the Year Award. For this slideshow, so give us just a second. Thank you.
Until you find a window, if it's cold outside,
Close to the end. We're getting close to what we all came for. Let me introduce someone who the last 7 years has been a great boss and a very good friend, our superintendent, Mrs. Rush.
Good afternoon. Parents, family members, and community members, we'd like to thank you for the opportunity to be a part of your child's life. We consider it a privilege that you choose to have your children attend the Holcomb School District. Thank you for letting us watch them develop their talents, their skills, and experience many successes. In so many different areas, we watch them music and drama, art, academics, athletics, other programs and organizations to become the people that they have become. They have so many strengths, and it has truly been an honor to be a part of your lives. Recently, I was at a ball game, and Mrs. Crane said to me, I think it was actually last week, Mrs. Crane said to me, well, Gina, do you have something ready to say? Because technically, I'm only supposed to get up here and say, you have completed the graduation requirements. But you know me, I have an opportunity to say something, so I have to give you my last little piece of advice. So, I told Mrs. Crane, I said, no, I haven't thought about that yet. And so I was at home, and I was going through a stack of Longhorn t-shirts, and I realized these shirts have a story to tell, and these shirts tell your story. So, my last parting advice to you, the first t-shirt says unfinished business. And today, excuse me, about finished business, because you crossed out the un when you became state champions in football this year. So you finished your business. So today we're here to celebrate your finished business again as you close this chapter of your story. So Monday, or the 1st of June, or in August, I hate to tell you this, you're going to go back to unfinished business and you write the next chapter of your story. As you go on, and your classmates have said what you're going to be pursuing, there's an important concept that I want you to remember, and that's this: your family. This is your home, this is your community, and your family loves you, and you know that life's not easy and life's not fair, and there's going to be challenges, but you have family. And your family may be extended family. It may be relatives, community members, people that have just shown you unconditional love. And I want to encourage you in whatever you do, whether it's in work or continued education, that you continue your belief in all together. You've demonstrated that, and I was very impressed when I heard some of you speak about how you feel about your classmates. You are all together. You support one another. You have supported each other the last 4 years. And I encourage you to do that the rest of your life. I think the most important thing, as I mentioned, family, and that's community. This community loves you. They've given a lot. They've given up their time. They've given up their resources. They've given up their finances to support you in your education. So I hope you remember your community, your Holcomb community, and I hope someday, if you go away to college or other training, that you remember your community, and I hope you come back. And here's the other thing I want to tell you, and that is doing something for each other, for one of your own. I hope you remember to put others first, for yourself. And as you go through life and you hit those bumps in the road, I want you to remember this final message, long and strong. You've survived and succeeded in a lot of things, and I encourage you, whatever you pursue, that you remember to maintain that long and strong attitude. I recently had a teacher send me an email, and in that email she said, "Once a Longhorn, always a Longhorn." So I want to encourage you to remember, once a Longhorn, always a Longhorn. Students of the Holcomb USB 363 class of 2018, you have successfully completed requirements set forth by the state of Kansas and the USB 363 Board of Education. By the power vested in me by the state of Kansas, I now pronounce you graduates of Holcomb High School. Congratulations.
As we get ready to recognize them and deliver their diplomas to them, to my right down here on the floor, is a great place for photographs. If you want to come down and take those as they're receiving their diplomas, that's great and fine. At this time, we're going to prepare the stage for the receiving of the diplomas of the graduates. First row, go ahead and stand.
Jonathan Eugene Arwater. Margarito Pablo Becerrell. Seth Becker. Carter Joseph Blackburn. Jaron Bolt. Megan Burrows. Chris Chandler. August Nicole Coates. Justin Collins. Peyton Howard Cornelson. Stephen Crane. Tasha Christine Dearden. Kobe Reed Dixon. Tanaya Renee Fairbanks. Sydney Faulkner. Efren Flores. Bailey Leanne Foreman. Yvonne Garcia. Trey Gilbert. Ulysses Aaron Quintana. Braden Jace Goddard. Cameron Star Gomez. Natalie Granados. Kyle Hammond. Braylon Rose Henry. Kayana Hip. Tiana Hip. Christina Roseanne Pendle. Madison Knoll. Remington Rustin Knoll. Joey Lares. Peyton Allen Leonard. Zeke Leva. Brina Linder. Alyssa Livingston. Octavio Benjamin Becerro. Devin Bader. Emma Christine Nagels. Jameson Martin. Chesney Rain McVeigh. Luz Bianca Munoz. Christopher Ryan Nemechek. Cameron Newman. Alan Dean Novak. Brittany Ray Novak. Albert Jesus Ortega. Eduardo Pacheco Olivas. Connor Palmer. Ethan Lane Perkins. Michael Curtis Peterson. Joshua Gage Pittman. Braden Ramirez. Jordan Ramsey. Zachary Raymond. Kirsten Lynn Richmeyer. Sheila Robles. Chance Joseph Rodriguez. Jaden Ruck. Maria Salamanca. Ebony Deshane Satan. Javier Serrano. Taylor Jean Sleet. Jordan Smith. Michelle Salarzano. Kenzie Nicole Soka. Hayden Spencer. Kenley Micah Segman. Caden Thomas Frederick Tischer. Derek Betty. Garrett Williams. Wilson. Courtney Danae Wren.
Before we close out today's ceremony, students, what the seniors will be leading here in just a little bit, will be forming a big circle out in the commons, and you can greet them and they'll receive you out there. A little housekeeping before that, this door to my right in the back, that's where they're going to be heading out, so everybody needs to clear that door right there as they get ready to head out here in just a little bit. Once all of our graduates are out, I think Javier back there will be the last one, and everyone else is welcome to head to the commons to congratulate them and spend some time with them. At this time, I'd like to ask the senior class to rise. If you have not already, you can move your tassel from your right side to your left side. Ladies and gentlemen, family, friends, board, staff, faculty, I present to you the Holcomb class of 2018.